Hello there, and welcome to Tusken Radio. I'm Drew Grech.
I'm Mike Badrov.
And we have quite the show for you guys today. We have set pictures for the Acolyte.
We got a Bad Batch trailer.
Bad Batch trailer and episode titles and episode release dates, and they're pretty exciting. And then we've got, and we talked about this a little bit last week, but we got the Mandalorian season 3 release date.
Yes.
And the writer's room was revealed, which is super exciting.
Let's get into it.
All great. Yeah, let's do it. So the first topic today is, it seems like the news for the Acolyte is just unending at this point. Like we've talked about it for like the last 3 weeks, right?
It's a really big trickle of information.
Yeah.
It's like a little bit, a little bit. And we enjoy it every time.
Oh, well, yeah, because I mean, I don't want to speak for you, but this is at least my favorite. This is my most anticipated Star Wars show that's upcoming.
I'm interested in it. After I figured out it was about the Jedi from their perspective, I'm a little bit less excited for it. I wanted it to be more from a Sith perspective. But either that, it's still live-action Disney and High Republic era, which is something new that we haven't tapped into before for mainstream Disney.
Yeah, exactly. So we have our first set pictures.
Yes.
From the show, and they are really exciting. So we have some pictures here of Lee Jung-jae as his Jedi character. He's like standing in behind some trees. It looks like he's on a spy mission, maybe. And he's, because he has his robe on.
It's gonna be really funny if they were negotiations.
Aggressive negotiations, though. We have another picture here of, looks to be a Padawan, because he's got the Padawan braid. Who's that actor? Because
I don't actually know. You'd have to check the cast list again.
Let's see. Dean Charles Chapman.
Yes, okay.
Yeah, from 1917, which was my favorite movie from 2019.
Beautiful, like, shots all around in that movie.
That's actually, I think, the one movie that I'd love to do a minute-by-minute podcast for. It'd be so, like, labor-intensive. I think it would be so much fun. We have our first look here at Daphne Keene as well, and she looks like a total badass. Sorry. So the site, the Bespin Bulletin, which is fairly reliable, they believe that it's Daphne Keene, but they're not entirely sure because she's in a lot of makeup and stuff.
Because she has the Zabrak makeup on it, right, with the horns?
Yeah, I'm excited because we've not really seen any Zabrak women.
We haven't actually seen many aliens in general. Andor was pretty much all human cast.
Yeah, but like, apart from the odd alien popping up every few episodes.
Right, but like Obi-Wan, Boba Fett, Mando. I mean, Mando has a couple of alien characters, but other than that, all the other characters have been strictly human casts. And so for this to have a lot more of a diversity in Star Wars is gonna be really cool to watch.
Yeah, so the Daphne Keene thing, I was actually really hoping that she'd turn out to be the Acolyte, you know?
Right.
I think that we know that's Amanda Stenberg, but.
Right.
It's just.
Bespin say she's the main lead for the show, but you don't have any pictures for her?
Yeah, I don't think we have any pictures. Oh no, we do.
We do?
Yeah, there's this one of her in a little, in a robe with a bow and arrow, which is so cool. We're gonna see a bow and arrow in Star Wars.
I hope it's like Omega's energy bow that we see in the Bad Batch.
I think it'd be cool. I was hoping that Daphne Keene would be playing a Sith just because, like, her, like, viscerality in Logan that we saw was so cool. Like, she almost was the standout of that movie.
I mean, we know the Acolyte from what we know from the story is it's the Acolyte infiltrating the Jedi Order, right?
Yeah.
So what if Daphne Keene is one of the people that the Acolyte turns?
That could be really
cool. We have to
assume
that the Acolyte is going in there to grab Jedi to the other side, like, a really tiny version of Palpatine.
Mm-hmm.
And so she's gonna do whatever damage she can to the Jedi, or they, because we don't know who the Acolyte is yet.
Yeah.
So pull over Daphne Keene, might happen.
I mean, Zabraks are mostly evil in Star Wars.
Don't we have like 3 Zabrak Jedi on the Jedi Council?
Do we?
Yeah, we got I'm blanking on their names now, which I'm disappointed in myself. But one of them survived the Jedi Order, Order 66, and the Darth Vader comics, Darth Vader killed him.
Got it.
Ithkoth.
Ithkoth.
Yes.
We have another picture here of another woman wearing the same sort of thing that Amanda Stenberg is wearing. And that actress is... I'm trying to find it on the site. I'm sorry. We're not sure. Looks like she was not announced as part of the main cast of the show. So, that's fine. And then we have one last image here of a little truck thing that's camouflages grass. I'm sure that's just a background thing.
Yeah, probably.
For the production. But yeah, I mean, so you saw these pictures. What do they... up your anticipation for the show? And by the way, we got a Wookiee Jedi in here.
We did not talk about, yeah, Wookiee Jedi, we gotta talk about
awesome.
That.
Awesome.
Adding more to the diversity of the Jedi cast, we all love Wookiees. I don't know anyone that hates Wookiees.
No one hates Wookiees.
Besides how much they scare the ever-loving crap out of me, because they can literally rip your arms off.
Just don't beat them in Sabacc.
Yeah,
it's okay.
I suck at chess anywho. but we get Goongi.
Which we're going to talk about later.
In Bad Batch.
Yeah.
And so on the theme of Wookiee Jedis, it's great to see some consistency. Pretty sure there's a Wookiee Jedi in the High Republic. I'm blanking on his names because I really don't care about those comics. But I don't even know if the show will tie into the...
I don't think it will, because the first whole series of books and comics was set 200 years before Phantom Menace, right?
Yes.
So this show is 100 years after that.
Okay, it said High Republic era, but I wasn't sure which time of that.
Kathleen Kennedy said it was the very tail end of the High Republic era.
Okay, so we may or may not see.
I mean, Wookiees also live to very old ages, and we have started to see some of these characters from the books and the comics come over to live action with Cobb Vanth in Mandalorian and Chris Stanton in Boba Fett.
Right.
So it's possible that this is the same character. Can you send me a list of the comics that he's in so I can just get caught up on the characters?
Like I said, I don't know for sure, because they were the High Republic comics and I read them in a fever dream.
I think I tapped out after four issues of the High Republic comic.
The first one we have somewhere in here.
The first one I thought was great, but then it just went downhill from there. And in my opinion, just the story didn't really captivate me.
But back on the show, because Angus is not here to be our reset button.
Yeah, so, I mean, yeah, I'm not like... overwhelmed with excitement by these images yet, but
these all read like episode one in images.
I think they're gonna be like episode one or episode two.
It's something in the beginning. They're not gonna be like that Tom Holland Spider-Man thing where at the end of it, where we all saw like the pictures of, oh, it's Christmas time, he's reading his lines. It's actually like the biggest spoiler for the movie.
I mean, set photos we can guess and speculate, but there's a 99.5% chance that we're wrong.
We're all wrong.
Yeah, I mean, I was going back through some of our Andor finale theories. They were all so far off.
I mean, the only thing we had right is that it all went horribly wrong.
Yeah, but that's also how just storytelling works.
Yeah.
I think that's probably going to do it for this segment here on the Acolyte. When we come back, we are going to be talking about the Bad Batch Season 2 trailer.
You got the shirt for it. I got the shirt for it.
I've got the Hunter Black Series figure for it. So let's do it.
Go, 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 go! We went over the plan 5 times.
I got the package, didn't I?
We need a pickup.
Hang on. Grab the light.
So, this is the top team. The rogue clones on the run from the Empire, huh?
Hello.
How juicy.
The Empire's growing stronger. We should be doing more.
You want to really be free? Then pull off this heist, and you can have a future.
Rumors are more and more clones have been questioning the Order.
Then they are traitors, like the Jedi.
You all gave up everything because of me.
We made the right choice, Omega. But there are others out there who need our help.
What sort of treachery is this?
Stay back!
Empire seeks to establish peace and order throughout the galaxy.
Peace? Peace
was never an option.
We're soldiers. We do what needs to be done.
Move. You know what makes us different? We make our own choices.
What do you need, Rex?
Any chance I could use you for a mission?
Parents, The Bad Batch. New season, streaming January 4th, only on Disney+.
Welcome back to Tusken Radio, and here we're going to talk about the Bad Batch trailer that just recently came out. What was it, yesterday?
Wednesday morning.
Yeah. Wednesday morning. I've already watched it 12 times.
I've seen it maybe a quarter as many.
It's math that I don't want to do right now. But it's a great trailer. It gives you a totally full insight of the plot of the story, and I'm really excited to talk about it. So,
well, yeah.
Drew, what were your thoughts?
So, all right. I was not the biggest fan of Bad Batch Season 1.
Yes.
I liked it. Thought it was good. I thought it was the best first season of any Star Wars animated show.
If we look back on the Spotify at Tusken Radio, we can definitely talk about when we first talked about that.
Oh, yeah. But it's just, it was a lot of
filler.
One of my biggest, I don't have a problem with filler per se, but it's just like one of my biggest complaints about Star Wars today in the Disney era is how everybody knows everybody else. And it was a lot of that.
Cameos was your biggest problem.
It was a lot of that. Which is one of the reasons why I loved Andor so much, because there were no cameos.
I don't know if I agree with like the holy crap the cameos were too much thing, because I kind of love when everyone knows each other. Like, oh, I know that character.
Oh, yeah.
I could have done that with the Martez sisters, but
oh my god, absolutely.
Because I know we all hate them, and we could have had a bounty hunter arc for Mandalorian. I mean, we don't hate them. It's just there could have been other things.
Here's my thing with the Martez sisters. I think that the majority of people's problem with that block of four episodes in Clone Wars Season 7 was the fact that it was
four episodes,
and it was the final season.
Right.
Like, I thought that the first episode of that arc was really good. I thought the second one was fine, and then those last two just I was so ready for it to be over.
It could have been two episodes, and we could have gone with one of the other unfinished arcs that you can watch on YouTube.
Exactly, like that Crystal Crisis arc, which is great.
I know, right? In the Bounty Hunter arc, where Cad Bane and Boba face off.
Yeah. All right, back to Bad Batch.
Back to Bad Batch.
So, we saw Cody.
We did see Cody. I'm very excited, because you know what this means? More Lego.
More Lego.
But we saw
More Echo. Or Lego.
Lego.
Lego, all right.
But we also do get more Echo.
Oh, yeah.
And some very emotional talks with Omega that we saw in the trailer. Omega is feeling some guilt and growing up, because she's actually aging a little bit faster than the other clones. At least from what I could see in the trailer.
Yeah, we also don't know how long it's been since the season one finale.
That is true.
One thing that Disney did that really surprised me was they put out the release schedule for all 16 episodes of the season.
16,
so it's the same as season one. But not only that, they gave us the titles.
Yeah, I didn't want to speculate anything, because the title can mean one thing, and then...
Yeah, exactly. But let's just run through these titles here, and these release dates. So January 4th, Wednesday, that's like a little bit under a month from now. I can't wait.
It's during Christmas break, so we get to watch that.
I'll be in Northern Michigan, so it's going to be like 3 a.m. drop for me. It's two episodes, but whatever, Star Wars. So January 4th, Episode 1, Spoils of War. Episode 2, Ruins of War. January 11th, The Solitary Clone. January 18th, Episode 4, Faster. 25th of January, Episode 5, Entombed. February 1st, Episode 6, Tribe. February 8th, two episodes.
Episode 7, of February 8th?
Yeah.
Wow.
Episode 7, The Clone Conspiracy, and Episode 8, Truth and Consequences. February 15th is Episode 9, The Crossing. February 22nd is Episode 10, Retrieval. On March 1st is going to be a super exciting day, because not only are we getting the 11th episode of Bad Batch Season 2 titled Metamorphosis, but we also get the Season 3 premiere of Mandalorian.
Yes.
And we'll talk more about that later. March 8th, Episode 12, The Outpost. March 15th, Episode 13, Pabu. March 22nd, Episode 14, Tipping Point. And March 29th, we had a two-episode finale.
Oh.
Episode 15, The Summit, and Episode 16, Plan 99.
Oh, nice. I want to say for like the middle stages, like Metamorphosis, Truth and Conspiracy. I really hope that's Commander Cody going like, oh, Order 66 was a sham. I'm gonna bring him back to the light side, pretty please. I just want Cody and Rex again, please.
Yeah, I mean, one of the other things that we saw in the trailer was someone had a line. I think that it was Cody about clones are starting to
deny the order,
which I think that's all gonna come to a head in Plan 99. Which
right.
I love that title. It's like the only like episode title that gets me excited for the season.
I feel really bad. What was the clone's name from the first season of Bad Batch? The commander, Captain, not Gray.
I don't remember.
That it was the captain on Ryloth that denied the order and all the clones around
it,
him.
It was someone that we knew before from Clone Wars, right?
No, he was a completely new clone. It rewrote the Kanan comics.
Was it Ree?
Not Ree.
So it's also clone trooper.
It's whatever.
Right? Yeah, it doesn't matter. It's just
but
a clone trooper.
He and his brothers, they all defected the order besides some of them that stayed. So that means that there is some division within the clone army about Order 66. Mm-hmm. It affected some chips more than others. And I love the hope that gives for the clone army. I really hope more defect.
Yeah.
Because that means I can be happy.
I think that this season is probably going to be what I hoped a lot of season one was. Because season one, that journey from episode 1 to episode 16, I thought that could have been shortened by like 30-40%, right? So
I was enjoying the animation.
Oh yeah, of course. The animation in the show looks absolutely gorgeous.
Right. New designs for the Bad Batch.
Were they?
It looks a lot. Yeah, they added a bunch more color and they changed up the armor just a little bit.
I like it.
But it's a lot brighter in the atmosphere. It seems a little bit more hopeful on the run. At least from the last season, they were on like muddy and gross planets. But this one, they seem to go more of a tropical vibe. So maybe the band of brothers takes their young adopted sister on a vacation. That's what it is.
Well, we also saw Bail Organa
right.
in the trailer. We saw the Senate. I was hoping for Mon Mothma, because after Andor, she is one of, I think, a top 20 Star Wars character for me.
Cool.
So I really hope that we see some Mon Mothma in this season.
And we have the overarching illuminating threat of the Clone Commando Force.
Yes.
That the Kaminoans produced. Which scare me a little bit, because clone commandos are the biggest clone force in the clone army.
Yeah.
And those guys, if you ever played the Republic Commander game, they are scary. But
all right.
I think that does it for the trailer.
Yeah, I think so. So now, we'll be right back talking about Mandalorian Season 3. I'm so excited for this one. So we'll be right back right after this.
This is the one that you saved? You are Azit's father. A clan of two. But you have removed your helmet. Then you are a Mandalorian no more.
Your cult fractured our people. Where were you then?
Did you think your dad was the only Mandalorian?
All right, kid. Hang on. You ready for an adventure?
And we're back now.
Whoop.
Final segment of this week's show. Mandalorian Season 3 has a release date. This was announced back at CCXP last week.
Talked about it, yeah, and we did talk about it last week.
Yeah, The Mandalorian Season 3 has a release date finally of March 1st, 2023.
I'm very glad for that, because that means just so much content after the Andor finale that we had.
Yeah.
We're going to have a little bit of drought here until January 4th, but after that, it just picks right up.
Yeah, I mean, so let's start off. I mean, The Mandalorian is a weekly show.
Right.
Right, it's a weekly show. So we can probably figure out, while Disney did not release the
episode count,
release dates. Yeah, well, we know it's 8.
We do?
That was in the writer's room thing, which I'm going to talk about in a second.
Cool.
So, of course, I already mentioned Chapter 17 is coming on March 1st. March 8th is 18, blah, blah, blah.
You guys know. Yeah, we can add a week to every date. Be fine.
Yeah. Season finale is April 19th, which leaves just a few weeks until May 4th, which I think we're going to get the Ahsoka premiere on May 4th.
Hopefully. Hopefully they have. They don't have to premiere something, but I hope they do. Because last year was Bad Batch.
Well, no, that was 2 years ago. Well, from this upcoming one, it was two years ago. This past May 4th, they didn't do anything.
Right. It was 2 years ago. That was no. It was the Siege of Mandalore.
That was 2020.
I'm screwing up my dates here.
So May 4th, 2020. Was the
Bad
series?
Batch. It was Bad Batch.
No, 2020 was the series finale of Clone Wars.
Right.
And then 2021 was the Bad Batch premiere, and then 2022 was nothing.
Right. And now we get back into the swing of things. Hopefully.
Hope so. But March 29th, it's going to be a big day because we're going to have the 2-episode season finale of Bad Batch.
Right.
And a new episode of Mandalorian.
Yes.
And probably also an episode of Secret Invasion.
Maybe.
Maybe. But yeah, so they also announced, not officially, but this is from the Writers Guild of America, so it's pretty reliable.
You would know about it more than me.
The 8-episode season, episode 1 is directed by is written by Jon Favreau. Episode 2, Jon Favreau. Episode 3, Noah Clore and Jon Favreau. Episode 4 is Favreau and Filoni. 5 is Favreau. 6 is Favreau. 7
is
Favreau and Filoni. And 8 is Favreau. So,
wow, Filoni had a lot less to do this than I thought.
Well, no, because that was the same for him with season 1.
I thought he had a little bit more.
He in season 1, he wrote and directed the series premiere.
Right.
And then also the Tatooine episode.
Oh, okay.
And then in season 2, he wrote and directed the Ahsoka episode.
Oh, of course, it's Ahsoka, so.
Yeah. But this is the first season of Mandalorian where Jon Favreau is a writer on all 8 episodes.
Which I'm very excited for. I think Jon Favreau is a great, he's a really good writer. I enjoy him. I know that he's not like the best, but what he does is...
He loves Star Wars.
He does love Star Wars. And I think he knows what to do with Mandalorian.
Oh, absolutely.
You can absolutely trust him. He's a very trustable writer.
Now, the thing is, and I don't think this is going to be a problem because they're two different shows, but Favreau was also the writer on all 7 episodes of Book of Boba Fett. He wrote all 7 episodes of that show, which I thought that those last 3 were great. Those first 4 were dragging.
Yeah, the show could have been shorter. I think they dragged it out too much.
Yeah.
But I appreciate Jon Favreau as a writer. I think he did a really good job with Iron Man 1.
Not so much with Iron Man 2. I'm not a big fan of that movie.
That was Joss Whedon.
No, it wasn't.
Still Jon Favreau?
It was Favreau, who wrote and directed that one.
I like Iron Man 2. I like it, just a little bit.
So Noah Clore is being added as an episode writer this season.
Can you go a bit more into them, her?
Him.
Him.
I believe.
Noah Clore.
Yeah,
why
Noah Clore.
Why are you getting into
Clore? So... He's been working, so he worked on the first 2 seasons of Mando, cool. And he was a staff writer on Boba Fett. So he was not credited with any given episode, but he was in the writer's room, like, contributing his ideas.
So
he did the same thing with Mando, though, so I think we can...
He has a lot of experience, and I think we can trust him, too, if Jon Favreau is going to be writing along with him.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
I think it's really cool that Jon Favreau... is going to be connected, which is from the first season of Mando, where it was different writers for every episode, right?
Yes. Mostly.
Mostly.
Yeah.
Because you had Taika in there, you had...
I don't think Taika wrote.
Taika wrote the last one.
I can check real quick.
He wrote the finale, I thought, with IG-88 blowing up.
He directed that, but he did not write it.
Did not write... I'm sorry, I'm messing up directors here.
It's all right.
I thought Tiger wrote one, but it's going to be really cool. That's all we get a connected writer.
So Favreau in season one wrote the first four episodes.
Right.
He did not direct any of them. He's not direct. The only episode that he's directed is the season two premiere.
Gotcha.
He wrote then episodes 7 and 8. And then season two, he wrote all of them except for 5, which was Filoni, and then 7.
Yeah, I was mixing it up. Yeah. I think it's fine. The trailer looks promising, and we know it's Mandalorian heavy. It's a Mandalorian war. It's going back to Mandalore, and we know how much Jon Favreau loves Mandalorians. He plays one. He is Pre Vizsla.
He's played two Mandos.
And yes, he's also
Paz Vizsla.
Paz Vizsla.
His cameo in Mando and Boba Fett.
And so we get to see all that again. We know how much Jon Favreau is interconnected with the Mandalorian universe, and to show his expertise is going to be instrumental for, or very utilized for this season.
Absolutely. I'm really excited for this season. I think this is also going to do what Andor did, which is going to bring the wars back to Star Wars.
Yes.
Because in the Disney era,
Andor really do shows, that?
I think season two is going to be more of the wars, but season one was...
Because this is a lot of espionage and behind-the-scenes stuff.
Yeah, but, I mean, Disney Star Wars with the shows, for the most part, has been a lot of star, not a lot of war. And I think that with the trailer that we saw at D23, we are going to get the wars back.
I do want a giant Mandalorian war. That'd be great.
We're going to get an epic space battle. First time in 4 years.
I'm hoping we get to see more of the X-Wings and the new growing New Republic that we will sadly see crushed in the sequels. Yeah. But I really like the New Republic aspect of the Mandalorian because it's something that we never got to see growing out of Return of the Jedi.
Yeah.
And to see that being a possibility with Dave Filoni as a pilot and seeing the X-Wings again, it's perfect.
One thing that I've always thought about the Mandoverse, as I call it, is... It seems like it's going to act as kind of a Clone Wars type thing for the sequel era, where Clone Wars filled in a lot of the gaps that we had from
the prequels.
Yeah. I'm really hoping that Mando does that for the sequel films.
Yeah, I know it's not going to be a whole rewrite of the sequels. It's not.
Oh yeah.
You can't do that.
It can't be.
But I do like what it does, and I have enjoyed it.
Yeah.
But I think that does it for the Mandalorian season 3.
I think so too. Yeah. I just can't wait. I just can't wait. So we'll be right back, or right after this little break. Yeah.
We came here to battle. Why you wanna kick me? Your style is no match for mine. You wanna fight? Yeah, my style.
So that's going to do it for Tusken Radio this week. Great show this week. I'm missing Angus, though.
Yeah, really light episode without him. I would like to hear his thoughts on all of this.
Oh, yeah.
He's with us as a Force Ghost spirit, as always.
He is alive, though.
Very much alive. Yes,
very
he's
much
alive.
And safe.
He's alive.
Well, he's across the street.
prepping for a debate tournament so we can speak his mind on various topics. We wish him luck.
Yes, we do. Good luck, Angus.
But great wrap up on Mandalorian season 3. Bad Batch, Acolyte, first in looks with pictures. Very promising to see from the start. I'm excited for the future of Star Wars.
I'm so excited for the future of Star Wars. It looks very bright. Very, very bright. So thank you guys so much for watching. I'm Drew Grech.
I'm Mike Badrov.
And may the Force be with you always. I have spoken.
There it is. Again.
I'm doing that every week.
Always time.